In 2007, Chicago convened a breast cancer task force to try to figure out why so many black men and women were dying of cancer. For black women, it's mostly breast cancer. For black men, it's mostly prostate cancer. And across the cancer industry, every doctor will tell you that cancers are known to be far more severe in African American patients than, let's say, Caucasian patients. But they don't understand why. And I'll tell you why. It's a very simple reason. It has everything to do with melanin in the skin. If you have darker skin pigmentation, because your ancestors came from a region closer to the equator, where sun exposure is more intense. And so the melanin in the skin is designed to block UV radiation. It's a built-in sunscreen. It's actually a feature. You know, black skin is a feature. It's a survival mechanism of those whose ancestors lived near the equator. But it blocks vitamin D production at the same time. You see, because the ancestors, all of our ancestors, were outdoors people. They spent their time outdoors. They didn't live in offices. They didn't work indoors all day long. So they had too much sun. And so the dark skin pigmentation blocked the excessive sun, and it protected them from UV radiation. Well, today, we all live indoors, don't we, for the most part? Indoor lifestyles, office jobs, even people who work in hospitals are working indoors. And when black people work indoors or live indoors, they become sunlight deficient, especially because of the melanin in their skin. So now that same feature of their skin that blocked excessive sun radiation in, let's say, Africa, now in New Jersey or New York, it's a detriment because it's causing African-American populations to become deficient in vitamin D. And this is what's happening in Chicago and Detroit, and especially the more northern latitudes of northern United States, Canada, and so on. Black men in the UK have very high rates of prostate cancer, and when they get diagnosed with prostate cancer, the prognosis is less positive than, let's say, a white person with prostate cancer. The cancers are more aggressive, they're more deadly. The answer is lack of vitamin D, and yet in 2007, this Chicago Breast Cancer Task Force convened, I think, over 100 doctors and nurses to try to have a powwow, a team effort to try to figure out why is cancer worse in black people in Chicago. And wouldn't you know it, after spending days or even weeks on this project, they couldn't come up with the truth. The truth that people with dark skin are sunlight deficient, they're vitamin D deficient, and that's why the cancer is more aggressive, because vitamin D halts cancer. And vitamin D can be purchased for a nickel a day. Every black person in Chicago, in Detroit, in New York, in the UK could prevent cancer. About 4 out of 5 cancers, by the way, with nothing but vitamin D. And yet the cancer industry won't tell them that. So here's a case where you have a disease that is disproportionately more aggressive in blacks versus whites. And white people, they absorb sunlight more efficiently when they're outdoors. So they need less time in the sun to generate the same amount of vitamin D as a black person who needs more time in the sun. And yet nobody is telling African Americans this simple truth, nobody. This information is being denied the black community in America. And it's just, again, a very small part of the overall vector that I'm going to be